This is the Jabberjaw Podcast Network.
Not everything metal was created equal.
What an ugly thing to say.
The Metal Sucks Podcast. Shiggity Chuck and Godless attempt to bring order to chaos or just make stupid jokes about dumb people.
Stupid. A person below normal intelligence.
This is the Metal Sucks Podcast.
Greetings and salutations, my fine metal friends. Welcome to another edition of the Metal Sucks Podcast Preview. How you doing? I'm Chuck.
I'm Godless.
And this is your weekly examination of all things metal, the Metal Sucks Podcast, but this is just a preview. Make sure that you are subscribed to this podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, wherever you get your podcast, because that way, whatever device you're using, Android, iPhone, iPad, it's going to come right to your device. But if that's not your thing, if you're a little lower tech, you can go to MetalSucks.net every single Monday and you can find the full version of this podcast. This week, we've got Evan Brewer from Entheos. You might have heard the name once or twice. You're thinking to yourself, where
Yeah, you've heard Evan Brewer once or twice. That's for damn.
Yeah, you heard that song.
Entheos, maybe not as many times. Yeah, you know? Entheos, but you're working on that.
Yeah, it's the new project, man. It's a new thing that he's been doing. You might know him from the Faceless and a few other 50 bands that he's been in because he's, you know, bassist extraordinaire. We get a chance to speak with him in this episode, and he's kind of an awesome dude, very good bass player. We actually talk about bass tone, which is weird, and it's strange hearing Godless talk about bass players.
But he did agree with me that most bands don't need a bassist. I thought that was pretty interesting.
That is kind of true. He did sort of agree with you there. So we also, in this episode, talk about Monuments dropping off their latest tour with the Contortionist and what that means for the future of that band. Poor guys. I'll tell you what. But actually, poor guys. Because apparently there's financial issues or something. They couldn't get to the next gig.
Yeah, that's one of the saddest stories ever, because Monuments are one of the greatest bands on Earth today. And they should be, like, you know, at this point of the tour, they should be like dumping all the cash in the back of the bus and then stripping down to their to underwear and just rolling in it. That's what they should be doing, but they're not, and that is criminal and perhaps immensely fixable.
They're barely getting White Castle at this point, so yeah, sorry guys, sucks. We also talk about Record Store Day and how Godless still doesn't like vinyl.
So stupid.
But has Record Store Day finally, like, jumped the shark? Is this the canary in the coal mine that tells us that vinyl may be passé at this point, maybe?
I love that. Hey, honey, I'm going off to work. And then he gets on his horse. You know, I mean, who does that?
You've lived so in stupid. Texas. We all do vinyl. That down here, man. What are you talking about? That's how you save money, man. You ride the horse to work. What you do.
Crank the Model T. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to crank the Model T before going to work today.
Well, whatever it takes, man. Whatever it takes. So I have to, you know, get my record player out and, you know, wind
you
it up
do
a
that,
little bit before
I'm going to sit in my house and I'm going to press a button. My car is going to warm up and use no fuel doing so. And then I'm going to walk out. The door's going to open for me and I'm going to go to work. I might not, in just a few years, I might not even be actually driving the damn thing. I'll just be sitting in there watching Netflix. And that is going to be super, super sweet. And you can crank your Model T with your record player and your life sucks.
My self-driving car will have a cassette player. So fuck you. All right, man. It's going to be awesome. I can't wait for it. Well, let's get a little piece of our interview with Evan Brewer of Entheos right here on the Metal Sucks Podcast Preview.
Now we got you. We got the BT Bam guys. It's like you all got a club. You sit around and, you know, watch, you know, thoughtful movies together or something.
Well, okay. Cool.
Or
there was no question there, so I mean, yeah, we don't.
I'm just you're supposed to either deny or affirm the accusation that you guys get together and watch movies.
I've never watched a movie with any of the people you mentioned. Actually, I don't think I've ever watched a movie with Alex Rudinger, even though we've been in multiple projects together.
Gonna have to set up a date night, I think.
Yeah, maybe a book club would be more my speed. I'm not really a movie guy. I'm like not really nerdy. Yeah.
Books. That's old hardcore. School. Are you electronic books or are you like books? Like, are you a paper book guy?
I'm a paper book guy. I'm old school.
Mm-hmm.
You're missing out. You know, I was torrenting books like crazy this week. Just like tons of knowledge that now I can put onto my Kindle and everything's good and I can pretend I know it.
Oh, torrenting ebooks, huh? Interesting. Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm a law-abiding citizen. I don't do that sort of thing.
Now that I've already crushed the music industry, I'm going after publishing. Single-handed.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
Are you a nonfiction guy or are you a fiction guy more?
Both. I'm coming around to fiction. I've been on a fiction kick lately. So it's sort of new for me. I used to not read fiction at all, but now I'm like, I like the entertainment value of it. It's cool. I'm into it.
I mean, like, just because you didn't want you weren't into the entertainment, or you're just into like learning, and that was what it was all about.
It wasn't because I didn't necessarily want entertainment. It was just more because I just don't think I'd come across fiction that I really like until kind of recently, actually.
I do so when I come across movies that, you know, about the books, and I go, yeah, but that book's really good.
Yeah, that's a good way to kind of reverse find stuff. It's hard to find good stuff to read in the fiction realms, I've found, you know.
Well, that all depends on what you enjoy. Like, you know, I mean, if you, you start with one thing, kind of like music, you know, you start with one thing that you love and you kind of spider out from that and find stuff and keep going.
Yeah, I guess it is. It's kind of the same. But there's not as much of a network, I've found, unless you know something I don't know. It's a way to say for fans of, or because, like, you could say, I like this band, and then you see them coming through on tour with a bunch of bands that they're probably similar to, and you can go check out those bands, and it kind of grows from there. Whereas, as far as I know, with books, there's only really kind of like genres, and beyond that, there's not much.
Yeah.
I remember going to see a band in concert that I loved, and they had on the bassist had a sticker on his bass, and it said Tree People, and I'm like, I don't know what that is, but I'm going to buy it, and I bought it, and it was the Doug March, who then went on to do Built to Spill, and it's just like, that turned into a whole, like, you know, thing where you just like end up going into the band after band, all these side projects, etc. You know, it's always kind of interesting how that worked out. You know,
that's a good example. I found out about some of my favorite bands because another band I liked was wearing the shirt, whereas I don't think authors really go around wearing other authors merch.
I don't know if it's
badass idea.
I don't know if it's Game of Thrones, man. They might wind up having George R.R. might have like a Tolkien shirt on somewhere, you know.
He might.
That's hilarious. Get the rest of that interview on the Metal Sucks podcast, MetalSucks.net. Click on the podcast tab up at the top. You can find all of our old podcasts. I think we're almost up to 150 now. Damn, we're getting pretty close anyway. So make sure you check out all of those old episodes. I actually had somebody tweet us the other day that said they started at the beginning and are about halfway through. They're like hitting four of them a day or something like that. I'm like, you are insane.
Kick ass.
Like, I feel sorry for that guy because once you catch up, you realize that it just is, there's no payoff at the end. There's just no payoff.
You're learning so much.
Sorry, brother. It'll be okay. But make sure that you catch up on those old podcasts. You can do it right there at MetalSucks.net. And, of course, if you subscribe to iTunes and all that stuff, you can get them there, too. So hit that. And find us on social media. I'm at Bearded Ape.
I am at Godless Speaks. Godless Speaks on Facebook. Godless Speaks on Spotify.
Instagram, you can dig us up at Chuck and Godless and ChuckandGodless.com. That would be our Patreon account, so you can support us right there if you would choose to. We have people that actually pay money for this piece of shit. No, it's pretty awesome. We appreciate every one of our patrons because they're rad people who really appreciate what we do, and that's like the biggest compliment that we could ever have, so we appreciate every one of you guys that are out there supporting us and our early adopters. So if you want to jump in, feel free to do so. All right, till next week, I am Chuck.
I am Godless.
And this is another Metal Sucks podcast premiere.
You've been listening to the Jabberjaw Podcast Network, jabberjawmedia.com. Shh.